Hey guys, welcome back to Insight Tennis Tour Stroke Series. My name is Rick Oldroyd. I'm the president and founder of Insight Tennis. And today we're going to talk a little bit more about the backhand slice. And what I want to do is talk about a couple of different positions that the pros all get into that is critical to hitting an effective backhand slice. And if you've wondered how they get so much penetration, Federer, specifically, that ball stays really low and knifes through the court. We're going to show you today exactly how that's accomplished. So a couple of things on the slice. Pretty much everybody knows that the universal grip, if you will, for the slice, the serve, the slice, and the volley is the continental grip. And the easiest way to find that is you're just going to take the racket and look at here's bevel number one, bevel number two. I want my index knuckle essentially on bevel number two and the pad of the hand on bevel number two. That's pretty darn close. I mean, again, there are some variations, but that's pretty close. Now, a couple of things on the slice. Everybody, whether you take the racket back with your racket here or whether you turn the racket like a lot of players do, Federer turns his racket back like this and rotates his wrist. You've probably seen that. Either way is fine. But the key element that you've got to get into is this first position. So let me show you what I'm talking about. So when I take my racket back on a good backhand slice, right, I get about to here, but when I'm ready to step into the ball, I'm going to release it back even farther. Now, even if I rotate my wrist forward or if I have my wrist like this, I'm still taking the racket back farther, okay? Now, here's the key. Once I get into this position, as I step into the ball and I get ready to come back down into the ball, this position right here is critical. Watch what I do here. As I'm coming down into the ball, my racket is going to rotate like this so that back here I look like this. So my racket is open. So it was here, right? Now, if I don't rotate my wrist forward, I can just take it back open automatically and that's fine. But you got to get into this position right here. So let me show you what I mean. So I'm going to take my racket back like this, and as I'm coming down, I'm going to open it up like that. Notice this position here. My racket face is essentially pointing up. My knuckles are pointing up. I'm open, right? So now as I come back down into that ball, the only way that I can get my racket back to contact is to come down and slightly rotate my racket back to contact. This rotation, this slight rotation back to contact, is a huge power source. Now we're going to actually do some demonstrations on the wall here for you in another video so you can kind of see what I'm talking about. But this is critical. If I don't get into this position here, then I've lost a ton of power, because if I'm just coming down into the ball and staying in that position, first of all, my racket's going to be too open at contact. Right? And as I go through the ball, there's just not going to be anything on that ball. So what allows the pros to really knife that ball and really drive it is this move. And so they're going to take the racket back. I'm going to show you two different ways, whether you take it back this way or whether you just take it back with the racket already open. You got to rotate back to contact. So here's the open example. I get to here, but I got to come and rotate back to contact so that when I make contact, my racket face should look like this, not like that. Okay? So here, and then I can come through and across. I can finish higher or lower depending on the type of shot that I'm trying to hit. But that is a key position. You've got to get there no matter what. If I take my racket back this way, and then I'm going to rotate it before, so I come from here and it rotates to there so that I can come back and rotate back to contact. And back contact, I can go through and finish higher, or I can come back and I can come down more, square my racket face up to contact, and come down and across the ball like Federer does. And that's why he gets so much knife to that backhand slice and why it stays so low. So go out and practice this, guys. This is key. Two things to remember. The two takeaways are, no matter what, you've got to get into that position right there on the backhand slice, whether you take it back this way or whether you take it this way. But in order to get your racket back square at contact, you've got to rotate. And this is a key element to that power slice. Boom, that move right there. So as I come back and bang, and across the ball. So I'll do that again. So I'm here, nice rotation, or nice starting my unit turn, ball's coming off the ground, and bang. That's what I wanna see. I wanna see that move right there. That's the key. That's exaggerated a little bit, but you get the idea. So the key position is that one right there. Gotta get in that position right there. And then as I come back down to the ball, I'm rotating my racket to square up. So from here, rotating. That's exaggerated a tiny bit, but you get the idea, okay? So it's that rotation, bang, that allows me to really drive that ball and knife that slice. Hopefully that's gonna be helpful for you guys. If you like the video, click the link below, subscribe to the channel. Check out the website at insighttennis.com. Also, leave any comments or questions below. Turn the notifications button on, obviously, so you get all of the new content as it comes out. And check out the website. If you have any questions or interest in lessons or clinics or anything like that, email me directly at rick@insighttennis.com. As always, guys, thank you so much for your time. We'll see you next time out on the court.